Site concentration is clear to you, and like I told you, you are asked name a natural limiting factor, that is CO2 concentration. Remember, light very rarely it cannot be a limiting factor because there is lots and lots of sunlight around us. Only in some forest area where there's a thick canopy of trees and very tiny plants are growing next to the ground, for them they are receiving very less light. So for them, light intensity might be a limiting factor, but it's not common in tropical countries like ours where we have lot of sunlight. So rarely light intensity is a limiting factor, and usually carbon dioxide concentration is the limiting factor. The third factor is the temperature. With the rise in temperature, rate of photosynthesis rises. But what should be the range? Optimum range is 20 to 35 degrees Celsius. An increase in temperature causes an increase in rate of photosynthesis. Again, it's not as simple as it sounds. Very low temperatures, below 10 you may say, are not good for photosynthesis because it is catalyzed by enzymes. And enzymes are proteins in nature, and their activity would get inhibited. Likewise, very high temperatures, that is above 40 degrees also, the enzymes are destroyed and photosynthesis will not occur. So this is the optimum temperature range for tropical plants. Very low temperatures, 10, below 10, very high temperatures, 40 or above 40, are not suitable. It was also observed that in this temperature range, for every 10 degree rise in temperature, say from 20 to 30, or 22 to 32, or 25 to 35, what happened? For every 10 degree rise in temperature, in this optimum range of temperature, it was observed that rate of photosynthesis doubled. You may write in your books here, this is known as the Q10 law. So please note down Blackman's law also with pencil, somewhere on the top space must be there, and write here Q10 law. So under temperature, what are the points you need to know? An optimum temperature of 20 to 35 degrees Celsius is needed for photosynthesis to occur. Very low and very high temperatures above 40, they have an adverse effect on enzymes. Low temperature would inhibit or check their activity, and a high temperature would destroy the enzymes because enzymes are proteins in nature. Secondly, you need to know that for every 10 degree rise in temperature, between 20 to 35, it may be anything, 20 to 30, 21 to 31, 22 to 32, 23 to 33, likewise 25 to 35, the rate of photosynthesis doubles up, and this is known as Q10 law. The last internal factor is the water content. This is also rarely a limiting factor because I don't know if you remember, I told you earlier that less than 1% of water taken up by the plant, less than 1%, is used for photosynthesis. But still, if there is too much scarcity of water, it leads to stomatal closure. When stomatal closure would be there, no CO2 intake would be there. Likewise, too much transpiration, less absorption would dehydrate the plant, make the cells flaccid, make the guard cells flaccid. Okay, that would lead to closure of stomata. Dried protoplasm would not be able to support photosynthesis. So water content is the fourth factor, but usually a natural limiting factor is CO2. Other limiting factor may be temperature. In a thick forest canopy cover, light might be a limiting factor. And rarest of all is the water content, which may be a limiting factor. But anyways, you need to know all the four external factors, and I've also already discussed internal factors of photosynthesis for you.